beloved in Christ, in this season of Advent, let it be our care and delight to prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angels, and in heart and mind to go even unto Bethlehem to see the babe lying in a manger. Let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought us by his holy child. And let us look forward to the yearly remembrance of his birth with hymns and songs of praise. But first, let us pray for the needs of his whole world, for the peace and goodwill over all the earth, for the mission and unity of the church for which he died, and especially in this country and within this city. And because this of all things would rejoice his heart, let us at this time remember in his name the poor and the helpless, the hungry and the oppressed, the sick and those who mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, and all those who know not the Lord Jesus or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember before God his pure and lowly mother, and all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom, in this Lord Jesus, we forevermore are one. The Almighty God bless us with his grace. Christ give us the joys of everlasting life, and unto the fellowship of the citizens above, may the King of Angels bring us all. Amen. Today we light the first and second candle of the Advent wreath. Each candle has a meaning. The first candle is hope, the second candle is peace.
A reading from the book of Genesis. Adam and Eve rebel against God and are cast out of the Garden of Eden. Now the serpent was more crafty than any other wild animal that the Lord God had made. He said to the woman, "Did God say you shall not eat from any tree in the garden?" The woman said to the serpent, "We may eat of the fruit of the trees in the garden, but God said, you shall not eat of the fruit of the tree that is in the middle of the garden, nor shall you touch it, or you shall die." But the serpent said to the woman, "You will not die, for God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was a delight to the eyes, and that there was to be desired to make one wise, she took of its fruit and ate. And she also gave some to her husband, who was with her, and he ate. Then the eyes of both were opened, and they knew that they were naked, and they sewed fig leaves together and made loincloths for themselves. They heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden at the time of the evening breeze, and the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" He said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." He said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman who you gave to be with me, she gave me the fruit from the tree, and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is it that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent tricked me, and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you among all animals and among all wild creatures. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring. And then he will strike your head, and you will strike his heel." Here ends the reading.
Reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord will rest upon the Holy One. A shoot shall come out from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide by what his ears hear. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall kill the wicked. Righteousness shall be the belt around his waist, and faithfulness the belt around his loins. The wolf shall live with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid, the calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze, their young shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the adder's den. They will not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. Here ends the reading.
Prophet Isaiah. God comforts his people and calls on them to prepare for redemption. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out. And I said, what shall I cry? All people are grass. Their constancy is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades, when the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. Get you up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of good tidings. Lift it up. Do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them in his bosom and gently lead the mother sheep. Here ends the reading.
A reading from the prophet Micah, the one who is to rule Israel will be born in the village of Bethlehem. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are the one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore, he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth. Here ends the reading.
Zephaniah, the Lord will be among us. We are summoned to rejoice and sing. Sing aloud, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O Israel. Rejoice and exult with all your heart, O daughter Jerusalem. The Lord has taken away the judgments against you. He has turned away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You shall fear disaster no more. On that day, it shall be said to Jerusalem, "Do not fear, O Zion. Do not let your hands grow weak. The Lord, your God, is in your midst, a warrior who gives victory. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will renew you in his love. He will exult over you with loud singing as on a day of festival. I will remove disaster from you so that you will not bear reproach for it." Here ends the reading.
Mm-hmm. A reading from the prophet Isaiah. God promises a new heaven and a new earth. For I am about to create new heavens and a new earth. The former things shall not be remembered or come to mind. But be glad and rejoice forever in what I am creating. For I am about to create Jerusalem as a joy, and its people as a delight. I will rejoice in Jerusalem and delight in my people. No more shall the sound of weeping be heard in it, or the cry of distress. No more shall there be in it an infant that lives but a few days, or an old person who does not live out a lifetime. For one who dies at 100 years old will be considered a youth. And one who falls short of 100 will be considered accursed. They shall build houses and inhabit them. They shall plant vineyards and eat their fruit. They shall not build and another inhabit. They shall not plant and another eat. For like the days of a tree shall the days of my people be, and my chosen shall long enjoy the work of their hands. They shall not labor in vain or bear children for calamity, for they shall be offspring blessed by the Lord, and their descendants as well. Before they call, I will answer. While they are yet speaking, I will hear. The wolf and the lamb shall feed together. The lion shall eat straw like the ox. But the serpent, its food shall be dust. They shall not hurt or destroy on all my holy mountain, says the Lord. Here ends the reading.
The Gospel according to Luke. The angel Gabriel announces to the Virgin Mary that she will bear the Son of the Most High. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Here ends the reading.
Merciful God, who sent your messengers, the prophets, to preach repentance and prepare the way for our salvation, give us grace to heed their warnings and forsake our sins, that we may greet with joy the coming of Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
right, we have a couple of announcements. Sarah.
Hi, I'm Sarah Evinger. Next week after church, we're going to give you a great chance to do some stocking stuffing and Christmas shopping and whatever, you know. Sylvia will be selling her beautiful scarves and some fingerless gloves. We'll have a beautiful assortment of hand-knit items and some homemade goodies as well. If you'd like to contribute some cookies or different things to our sale, that would be really great as well. I just wanted to show off this fabulous hat that Sally Sadler has made. It is a Fair Isle hat knit on some of the smallest needles that exist. And so it will be for sale at the event. It will follow the church service when we're going to have Pastor Vinny with us. And the proceeds from the sale will go to Pastor Vinny. In addition to the food we provide, in addition to the hats that I make all year that go to our folks who are out in the cold, we try to help him out too as he helps people get medications and things. You know, if you don't have an address, if you don't have health insurance, it gets a little tricky, and it doesn't mean you don't have high blood pressure or some other health issue. So we really look forward to this event. We look forward to your attending with us and helping us out.
Thank you. Did you need to make an announcement?
Good morning.
Good morning.
If you read this week's bulletin, or Friday email,
oh, yes,
you will have found no errors, as opposed to the week before, where there were some spectacular errors. Impressive. They were impressive. Well, they came, with all honesty, from too much turkey and maybe a little too much Chardonnay at 10 o'clock on Thursday night. So that's my excuse, and I'm sticking to it. The Montclair stroll is coming up.
And here we eliminated the prayer of confession today.
I know, I needed it. I needed it, believe me. You were all but two of you were very kind. And you know who you are. The Montclair stroll is coming up, I believe it's on the 8th.
Thursday
the 8th. We are going to have a booth again, as usual. We always have lots of crafts for the kids and cookies and hot cider. If you possibly can help with either setup or takedown, or even to stay and man the booth, as they say, or person the booth.
I don't know.
Staff the booth. Thank you very much. We would really appreciate the help. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you, Kathy.
Setup is at 4:30? 4:30, and takedown will be probably about 8, but it starts at 5:30.
5:30 to 8:30 is the time of the stroll.
Yeah.
So, thank you for that. Isn't it great to have this Lessons in Carols? I love it. I love the music. Not only does it lower the average time of my sermons, but the music is wonderful. Thank you, choir, for the work you put into this. And thank you, Ben. I think that was there one other announcement somebody mentioned to me? Nope. Okay. Again, I invite you to take a look back to the back of the church. Thank you, Bill, for rolling in the coat racks and the bags of clothing that have been donated yet again this week. Thank you all for your continued support of Vision. We will bless those coats in a moment, and which will go out to be and hold in warmth those that are on the streets. So we're very, very grateful for that in this time of great need. I also want to invite you, you probably saw the announcement following the service, immediately following the service, those of you who would like to participate in our first of 5 conversations about the master planning, the facilities plan that the vestry has been overseeing. We would love to have your input and your ideas, and for you to be exposed to what has been evolving, even during the pandemic, which was really an amazing feat. We just ask that you bring your coffee up. There's no coffee up there, but there is breakfast. There's quiche and some other treats up there. So please feel free to join us either this week, next week, the week after that, or 2 weeks in January, which we will inform you of. All right. Well, in fact, we were going to do a birthday anniversary prayer. Would you lead it?
Because we have a second birthday.
Because it's my birthday.
It's my birthday.
I'm sorry to spring that on you. Thank you. Other people, birthdays, anniversaries, transitions. All right.
Thursday, right, Scott? One quest scroll is for you.
It's Wednesday. It's Wednesday.
All right.
Wow.
My goodness.
Excellent. Okay. There was lots of fun being had.
Birthday this week? Oh. Catherine's grandmother and dad. Richard, it's your birthday? Is it your birthday? Oh, fantastic. Okay, great. Sydney and John's birthday and anniversary. Mark and Mary?
Birthday.
Birthday for Debbie.
Okay. Join me in the birthday prayer. Oh God, our times are in your hands. Look with favor, we pray, on these your servants as they begin another year. Grant that they may grow in wisdom and grace. Strengthen their trust in your goodness all the days of their lives. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
What that basket of straw is for? It's for
God's bed.
It's what?
God's bed.
It's for God's bed. Okay, you're right. Yes, Catherine.
It's Jesus's bed.
Yeah, okay. So how do we make that bed comfortable?
Putting
straw in it. You know, so this is something that we do every year. We put one piece of straw in for everything kind that we've done this week, or the kindness we hope to do in the coming week. Can you think of something kind that you did this week? Yeah? They're very tight with what it is they were kind. So this is a wonderful thing to think that, see all that straw in there? That represents a whole bunch of kindness that people in this church have been offering this last week. So that's what we want you to do. During communion, each of you, if you can take a straw and place it in the manger, we will prepare for the birth of Jesus that way. What if what? Whatever works for you. That's good. Now let us bless, certainly an act of kindness, all those who donated to this week's coat and clothing drive. Let us pray. Loving God, we thank you for the opportunity to be generous, the opportunity to be mindful of those who are less fortunate than ours, those who are facing hardship on the streets of Oakland and beyond. We ask your blessing to be not only on this clothing, but upon those who will wear it and receive it. May the awareness that they are not forgotten also go with them, these offerings to them. This we ask in your name. let us with joyful hearts offer the fruits of our life and labor to God. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the living God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is truly right and a good and joyful thing to give you thanks, all holy God, source of life and fountain of mercy. Because you sent your beloved Son to redeem us from sin and death and to make us heirs in him of everlasting life, that when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may without shame or fear rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore, joining with angels and archangels and with the faithful of every generation, we lift our voices with all creation as we sing. Blessed are you, gracious God, creator of the universe and giver of life. You formed us in your own image and called us to dwell in your infinite love. You gave the world into our care that we might be your faithful stewards and show forth your bountiful grace. But we fail to honor your image in one another and in ourselves. We would not see your goodness in the world around us, and so we violated your creation, abused one another, and rejected your love. Yet you never ceased to care for us and prepared the way of salvation for all people. Through Abraham and Sarah, you called us into covenant with you. You delivered us from slavery, sustained us in the wilderness, and raised up prophets to renew your promise of salvation. Then, in the fullness of time, you sent your eternal word, made mortal flesh in Jesus. Born into the human family and dwelling among us, he revealed your glory. Giving himself freely to death on the cross, he triumphed over evil, opening the way of freedom and life. On the night before he died for us, our Savior Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." As supper was ending, Jesus took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Remembering his death and resurrection, we now present to you from your creation this bread and this wine. By your Holy Spirit, may they be for us the body and blood of our Savior Jesus Christ. Grant that we who share these gifts may be filled with the Holy Spirit and live as Christ's body in the world. Bring us into the everlasting heritage of your daughters and sons, that with all your saints, past, present, and yet to come, we may praise your name forever. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, to you be honor, glory, and praise forever and ever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. All are welcome at this table. Thank you. body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Let us pray. Loving God,
we give you thanks for restoring us your image and nourishing us with spiritual food in the sacrament of Christ's body and blood. Now send us forth a people forgiven, healed, renewed, that we may proclaim your love to the world and continue in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen.
And now may we, as we go forth, may we be filled with the stories and the music of this season. May they bring us delight, and may we be the source of delight to others. May the blessing of God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, be with you now and evermore.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God.